we go. Okanog Lake. Really fishing, baby. Let's go. Well, that was nice rainbow trout. That one was about 3 pounds, 22 inches. It was good. So, I want to talk about plugs. I'm calling this video Plugs Unplugged. I live in Okanagan. For those of you who don't know, that's a region in the interior of British Columbia, Canada. Our winters here aren't very cold as far as Canadian winters go. And some of the larger lakes around, like Okanagan Lake, Kalamalk Lake, Shuswap Lake, they don't freeze. The fish tend to be a little bit more lethargic through the winter, but come spring, the water's starting to warm up and the fish are pretty aggressive. And the rainbow trout are actively coming into shallower waters, top layer of the lake, where the oxygen levels are ideal for them, and they're feeding on fry, different kinds of fry as they come out of the creeks and rivers into the lakes. And it's just a great time of the year to fish. They're aggressive, they hit hard, they fight hard, they're fattening up. It's a lot of fun. So this time of year, I'll tend to use bucktails and plugs. This video is focusing on plugs. I'm going to share with you some of my tips, how I set up my rods, my setbacks I use, and watch till the end, and I'll be sharing with you my favorite plug in the Okanagan this time of year. Thanks for joining me. Don't forget to subscribe, ring that bell so you get notified when I release new videos. Okay, let's start off. Let's talk about rods. I use a couple setups for different reasons, but I particularly like these two setups. They weren't very expensive to get rigged up, and they work well for me. So the first one I want to talk about is a line counter rule. I use a low profile. This is a Convector by Akuma. And it's a Kokanee Black, also rod by Akuma. The Kokanee Black is a medium light action, which I guess you could argue might be a little light for fishing large rainbow, but I find it has lots of backbone, and I like the soft touch. When they hit hard, it's almost like the rod will absorb some of that initial impact. And what I'll do is, I've got some backing on here, but I'll spool it up with some braid, and quite a bit, like 150 yards, 200 yards of braid, 30-pound green color braid. And then on the end, you can see this isn't braid. On the end, I'll tie to that braid about 40 feet, 50 feet of fluorocarbon. And that just helps with visibility, and then I'll talk about how I terminate that in a minute. So by the way, there are affiliate links below in the description of this video if you want to check them out. I know that there's some local shops that also sell Akuma brand and other brands of line counter reels. The line counter comes in really handy when you're letting out your line, obviously, and we'll talk about that in a minute. Next is, because it's a lot more fun, I have this large Arbor fly reel. Again, there's an affiliate link below in the description, and I have the fly reel on a 8-9 weight fly rod. This is an old fly rod I've had for a while. It's nothing special, but it really does the trick and is a lot of fun when you got 6, 8, 12 pound rainbow on your line. So this particular one, you can see I've got some braided backing on it, and then also some green braid, 30 pound braid. And then I do the same thing, 40, 50 feet of fluorocarbon. I tend to use the Seaguar 15-pound fluorocarbon on there. And like I say, it's a good setup, works for me, and it's a lot of fun when you get a good-sized fish on there. Now let's talk about how I terminate the setup. Like I say, I've got the 40, 50 feet of fluorocarbon tied to my braid. And then what I do is I terminate with a bearing swivel, a bead to protect the knot, and then this sinker slider. And the reason I do that on both the rods, is that allows me, if I want, depending on how rough the water is, where I'm marking fish, I can attach some little weights to this, 1 ounce, half ounce, eighth ounce, whatever I feel. If I want to get the plug down a few feet below the rough water, sometimes you'll actually mark the fish just below the turbulence of the top waves, and I might want to add some weight. Some plugs dive more than other plugs, so I find that's pretty handy. Quickly add some weight and get your plug down a few feet. And then I tie to that. I really like to use some tippet material. So this particular tippet I use is the Rio brand 15 or 13 pound tippet. It's just really, really almost invisible to fish. Very fine for the strength of it. And I'll put 4 or 5 feet of this tippet on the end. So I don't feel like the fish, this little setup, I don't think that deters the fish at all. So really, you got about 40 feet of fluorocarbon, and then this setup, and then another 4 or 5 feet of very thin, almost invisible tippet in front of your plug. So that's my setup. First one of the day, little rainbow, reeling and fishing. Let's go. Okay, I've got an assortment of plugs here, a few different brands. Full disclosure, I don't have any endorsements with any of these brands. Some of them are made locally, and which I love to support, and all of them you can buy at the local fishing shops, or you can order them online as well. So first off, setbacks in early light. So early in the morning, on cloudy, rainy days like it is today, in the afternoon, late afternoon, evening, I'll tend to let 200, 250 feet out behind the boat. And like I showed you before, I might put a little bit of weight on them, or I might not. And I'll just let them out there. And then I'll pull them, I'll vary my speeds a lot, do a lot of S-turns between 2.5 and 3.5 miles an hour. So let's get into it. Okay, so the old adage, dark days, dark colors, bright days, lighter colors, holds true when you're fishing with plugs. You'll see in the summertime, I'll tend to use some of these brighter patterns and go down deeper. I use a lot of rainbow trout type patterns, right? Here's an older Lyman plug, still made out of wood. I prefer the Lyman plugs, the older ones that are made out of wood. And this would be a new Lyman plug. It's made out of they still work well, but made out of a plastic of some kind. This is a J plug. They're really common in Ontario when I used to fish in Lake Superior. I find they wiggle really fast, and they work really well trolling at slower speeds like you would for salmon, and that's what I used to use them for in Lake Superior. But I still use them here. They're great. I have this really cool setup that I use. It's a J plug with just a single hook. Kind of a homemade jobby. And then in front of it, I have another small J plug. That just really gives it a lot of action, a lot of flash on those cloudy, rainy days, or when it's glowing a lot. I let this out 200 feet or so, 250 feet, and pull it pretty fast, 3 miles an hour. And that's a great little homemade setup. And I have a bead chain in the front of it. It's a good setup. And lately I've been using some of these Lucky Plugs. Lucky Bug Company. They work pretty good. I'm just getting to use them now. This particular one has some glow on it. So I'll use that Okanagan Lake 40 feet or so in the fall, early morning, evening. Seems to work well. Right now, you've probably seen some of my videos. These are two Lyman lures that have been doing really well in Okanagan Lake for me. 2.5, 3 miles an hour in that range. Probably 2.8 is probably the most, where I'm getting most of the fish on these. And then, this is made by a local company here in the Shuswap Blind Bay, out of Blind Bay. It's called Fishnator Lures. This has been a really good one on Okanagan Lake really early in the morning. Flat line, so 250 feet behind the boat, 2.8 miles an hour. It's been really, really good. Later in the fall, I really like this Lyman. It mimics a spawning kokanee. So when the kokanee start spawning and staging up in front of the creeks, I like to find them and rip this through. And it's been really good for trout feeding on those kokanee. This one is made by a local company called Harley Lures. You can see it's called the Shovel Nose Plug. It's got quite a sharp angle to the front of it. It dives 10, 15 feet, trolling at 2.5 miles an hour. It is great, but you got to make sure, if you're running this one, to remember it dives, so you want to set your downriggers above the fish, or it's a great one to flatline with 200, 250 feet behind the boat. Pull that, and it's a pretty awesome plug. So, I'll tend to use a gold on a rainy day. There's just something about rainy day and gold lures, so I'll tend to use that. Last thing to talk about is the knot. So, for me, I spend a lot of time making sure my knots are strong, and I use what's called a perfection knot. So if you look at that really closely, there's lots of videos online about how to tie a knot. So you have a loop there. Some of the manufacturers of these plugs talk about connecting it to a bead chain. I put the bead chain, as you already saw, at the front of my leader. I really like the plug to have just complete freedom to do its thing. Now my favorite fishing Okanagan Lake is the Shazam pattern. There it is, folks. Shazam pattern Lyman plug. Works really well. 2.6, 2.8 miles an hour. Find the bait fish. Get this, just rip it through the bait fish, and good luck. It'll get you some rainbow trout. So there you go. Some plugs, some of the brands I like to use, some speeds, some tips. Hopefully it helps you catch more fish. I'm Real Russo. This is Reel It In Fishing. Don't forget to subscribe. Hope you like these videos. I'm enjoying making them. We'll see you out on the water soon. Check that sucker out. Woo! There you go. Reel it in fishing, baby. Okanagan Lake.